Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to my corner of the internet. My name is Jason, and today we're back with some more Distant Worlds universe. Last time, we ran into some trouble with the, was it Menacing Ravagers? The legendary pirate faction, and, we located their, what I believe to be their main base. So we're probably gonna go ahead and launch a mission against them to, destroy that and sort of take them out of commission. Because, they're getting on my nerves a little bit. I don't think we did it in the last episode, but we've recently switched over to the Way of Darkness, which is admittedly not doing us any favors, we'll say, in the, relations department with some other, factions. If we take a look, most people are angry or annoyed with us, and even the Acilus Major Enclave, is only sitting at plus 46 with us. They're still delighted, but even with, our ambassador, I guess that envy is really getting to them, because if you look at this, we covet your colonies and resources. So minus 15 plus another minus 7 because of their envious of our huge strength and power. But, they are quite dependable, so I'm hoping that they don't back out on us. And I'll give them, let's go ahead and give them some gifts to make sure that we keep our relation good with them, as well as the Great Canadian Territory, they're friendly with us at plus 30, but I want to make sure that we stay on very good terms with everyone here. On that note, though, we're still sort of searching for who our next, a member of our mutual defense pact. Who's going to join up with us as part of that sort of a victory condition? I had thought about the Great Meridian Alliance for a little while, but they're annoyed with us. We've actually got a kind of a strained relationship, and I think that it's not a whole lot to do with the Way of Darkness. They just don't like that apparently we are infringing on some of their territory. Like I don't even see where our borders touch, so I'm not too sure what they're so upset about there, but anyways, that's what it is. Now, I do see here, it looks like we have some destroyers heading over here from, once again, from the Menacing Ravagers. I'm wondering if they're going to go ahead and try to assault the planet MC Hammer yet again. MC Hammer is still building its defensive base again. It does have the medium spaceport up, and it does appear that we have what fleet is this? That's Strike Force Bravo. Strike Force Bravo and Charlie are both in system, so this should be an interesting encounter, because they are almost in system, so we'll get to see, our two secondary strike forces, go ahead and, interact with the legendary pirate faction, and we'll see just how legendary these guys really are. They have quite a few ships, but I'm pretty confident that we're going to be able to win this one. So, let's go ahead and speed time up just a little bit, because I want to see I want to get them in system here. Alright, so we've already got one warping in, and what is that? That's a frigate? Oh, give me a break! Okay, there we go, there's the larger ships, we got a carrier. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to have Strike Force Bravo focus fire on this carrier. And then I'm going to get maybe Strike Force Charlie to focus fire on this capital ship. And we're going to basically just sort of focus in on their large ships and see how that turns out for us. They've definitely got some shield strength. Wow, they are really doing a lot of damage. What is the size on that ship? 745. They do have some tough ships. I think we may go ahead. We may actually lose a ship or two here in this fight. Dang. I don't know if we're going to actually take these guys out. Nobody's warping out, though. That was a concern of mine. I was like, oh, watch, they're going to warp out a system, and then we're going to have to chase them down. But it looks like this carrier is going to go down, and it looks like the capital ship is going to go down as well. Have we lost anyone yet? I haven't been able to really tell. No, it looks like our shields have actually been able to hold for the most part, so this is definitely, we'll say, a failed attack by the Menacing Ravagers. Yep, they have some tough ships, but we definitely have the numbers right now. Yeah. All right. There we go. There's a nice blow to the Menacing Ravagers. Legendary pirate faction, my rear. All right. So, I'm fairly confident that our planet will be safe. I noticed a lot of ships were coming into the system, though. I was expecting more to show up, but maybe I overestimated the number? I don't know. Yeah. I find I get like that. I tend to worry a lot when I'm playing this game. When I see any sort of thing that looks like a potential threat, I find I tend to, I guess the term would be over-exaggerate. I tend to get very, very focused on the idea of losing, and I tend to overcompensate, so I have a very bad eye for eyeballing, we'll say, what are equal forces, so I'll see something and I go, but you know, that's probably because I wasn't actually taking a look at what their fleet composition was made up of. You know, if I would have known they had frigates mixed in with that, then, you know, that could have definitely colored my view of how well they were going to do. So yeah, that carrier is going to go down, and this guy here decided to, he decides he wants to come in towards the planet, which is going to put him right into the line of fire, and this guy's likely going to go down as well. So we're going to get Strike Force Bravo to attack them, as well as Strike Force Charlie. That ship's going down as well. He's not he might get away, but he's not going to be successful with whatever. Okay, so we've gone ahead and we've fended off another attack by the Menacing Ravagers, and we took out one of their capital ships. We did a decent amount of damage to them there. So once we get our guys all assembled, like I said, we'll, you know, with Strike Force Alpha as well, we're gonna go on in and just wreck their base, and that should be the end of this so-called legendary pirate faction. Now, at the beginning, when I set up the game, I did set it so that pirate factions respawned. So I'm wondering, if we destroy the Menacing Ravagers, will that remove them from the game entirely, or will they respawn? That's something I need to consider. Is it more worth it for me to go ahead and let's go ahead and take a look here? I'll show you what I'm thinking. Does it make more sense for me to destroy maybe the star base and maybe these two defensive bases, but leave one defensive base so that they're not entirely destroyed? That way they don't respawn. I'm wondering if that is something worth doing. I don't know. I'll have to do a little bit of thinking on that one. But I'm really loving having these exploration ships with the long-range scanners on them. I can sort of, you know, put those all around and kind of get a set of eyes elsewhere. It's very, very cool. So with that out of the way, though, I don't like what's happening over here by the Desolation Moon Project. Last time we noticed that other empires are building it. And I'm very much so considering just destroying it. I don't feel like I don't feel comfortable with that there, because I would have to declare war on this other empire, and I don't necessarily want to do that. I want to be able to try to stay at peace but still protect this as my territory. So what I'm wondering is if there's some way that we can sort of colonize something close to here. It doesn't really look like it. There's a planet here, our system. Sidisi. Wait a second. And that's owned by the Royal Ketarov Dominion. Huh. Well, why is that not showing up on my map? Yeah, let's go ahead and let's zoom in on this here. Wait, where'd it go? Sidisi? There we go. It shows right here that it's owned by these guys. Well, how on earth did you manage to get there? Oh no, wait, that's not colonized, you idiot. They have a mining base on it. Oh, I'm sorry people. Sorry. It's early in the morning and I sometimes I stupid. A new intelligent agent named Yuri Boralia has appeared at the Blue Planet. So let's go ahead and take a look at Mr. Yuri Boralia and what he is capable of doing. Well, we're getting a lot of intelligence agents. I'm glad we've got that spy agency thing going. Let's see. Untested in espionage. You know what, guy? Let's go ahead and get you, let's get you on a mission. I'm actually curious about this Royal Ketarov Dominion. We've already determined that that's just a mining base, but I still want you to steal the territory map. The reason why I'm sending him out on this is his territory maps are very good first missions. Just kind of figure out where they are at. We'll say skill-wise. And let's see, you're still stealing research information. And you will be done in just a few months. So we're going to go ahead and send him off to get the map of this... Was it this one right here? Yeah, this green faction right here. Yeah, they're pretty well expanded. They're pretty big. But yeah, I need to start thinking about where to actually, we'll say, expand out to from where I'm at. I had thought about... You know, I could actually probably colonize this planet right here. Sidisi, and it says no, unable to colonize, and that's probably because it's an ocean planet, and we don't have the technology to be able to colonize an ocean planet. So, let me go ahead and take a look at a high-tech and industrial, and right here, ocean colonization, let's go ahead and queue that up. It's going to be quite a while before we get that technology, but I would like to get that technology so that we can, if we colonize out here, then we can push our border up here, and then we can actually start shooing, we'll say, people out of our system here. Actually, Nembran Junction, we could go ahead and colonize this one. It's very low quality. It's very unlikely someone else is going to want to take this planet because of the low quality. But if we can push our, if it will help us push our border down, I think it's a good, we'll say, strategic colonization. So I'm actually going to go ahead and queue up a colony ship to take this area here. So we're going to be pushing a little bit over in this direction. You know, hey, who knows, maybe we are going to start butting heads with the Hakonish. Let's see, how powerful are the Hakonish? We haven't really interacted too much with them. They seem, wow, they are at the very bottom. On victory conditions, what about military strength? They might as well be near on the bottom. They are, what, 17th place? Strategic value, 19th economy. Their economy's alright, it's about on par with the Gazurian conformity, but we saw that we were able to crush the Gazurians, so... Yeah, I'm not too worried about that. Territory-wise, yeah, they're pitiful. Population, 19th. Yes. Yeah, we're gonna start ticking these guys off a little bit. Because they just don't have the power to resist us. So I'm gonna push on the... I'm not trying to take over their territory or anything, I just want to make sure that I secure the, Desolation Moon. I like playing with the basically sort of with the understanding that I don't like starting the wars, but whenever someone starts one, I use that as my opportunity to go ahead and expand my empire. As it stands, this is like one of the very few, we'll say, unclaimed parts of the galaxy, because we look around the map, most of it's kind of filled in. It's actually kind of looking kind of cool. Let's go ahead and hit, let's take a look at the entire galaxy map right now. So that's really cool. We got our faction in here. Looks like the Acilus Major is... kind of split a little bit. Hopefully you guys can sort of reform or reconnect a little bit. Serves our allies here. So if we consider us and our allies, we own basically all this. Technically we subjugated the Gazurians, so it's all this and that. So it's kind of cool. Like we've got control over a large portion of the map. And I guess that's kind of evident in when you look at you know, victory conditions. Alright, our agent, Yuri Boralia, has been captured while preparing to steal the territory map of the Royal Ket- Ah, what is with these new guys? They're pretty terrible. Alright, well, you know what, guy? I'm very sorry. So, you know what, let's, Here, have a gift. We'll try to forget this whole thing happened. Basically, we're paying them off. Yeah, we sent a guy over to your place, but and you killed him, but here, have some money. Yeah, because our cash flow is actually doing rather well, which is kind of surprising considering all of the ships I've queued up. Basically, I explained last time that I had gone ahead and I queued up a bunch of escorts and frigates. And the reason why I did that is I wanted to have some more, we'll say, roaming defense. Let's go ahead and take a look. What is this ship here? That is a frigate. And what happens is, in addition to the defense fleets that are, you know, protecting our colonies and the mining bases in around those colonies, I've also got sort of other defensive ships that are sort of flying around patrolling along with, say, civilian ships and construction ships. And what they do is they work well as sort of a deterrent slash, let's say if a pirate attacks or something, they're a good early warning, or they're good for holding off the enemy a little bit while maybe a more valuable unit can escape. So, and not only that, but it also boosts our apparent military strength. So it makes us look more intimidating to the AI as well. So that's why I've gone ahead and I've sort of started, we'll say, actually using escorts and frigates for defense. For most of the game, I've tended to use larger ships like the cruisers, because the larger ships are honestly better. They're just straight up better. What? Okay, so somebody from the Kalarba Major Confederation was sabotaging some of our construction. Where are you? Kalarba, isn't that a pirate faction? Kalarba, where are you? Yeah, there's so many factions to keep track of right now. What was I saying? I was saying something. I don't know, but I'm sure it was brilliant, and yes. There we go. Yes, I was saying something brilliant, just agree with me. I'm sorry. It'll come to me in a bit. Oh yes, basically the larger ships are just all around better, but there is a use for the smaller ships. I do feel that they are maybe a little bit, we'll say a little bit on the useless side. It is a little unfortunate to say that or to sort of feel that way, but ultimately. They are pretty useless, but there is a sort of use for them, because they tend to, especially if you leave things automated, like just the standard ships automated, like for example escort aimless prize here. We have an escort flying along with what are you flying along with? Aimless prize, that would be, is this? I'm not sure which ship it is. Wild Miracle. Basically, it's traveling with another ship, and it just adds security for your empire here. They want more. They want a release from subjugation. They keep asking. I'll think about it. Our two agents got back from their mission, as well as, actually, let me see here. Our agents completed research in intensified shield strength. And that was, I believe, a technology we stole. So, let's take a look at intensified shield strength. Okay, that's fine. I was going for accelerated shield recharge, but we need these technologies anyways to be able to get to advanced shields. So, I'm going to be looking for maybe high storage capacitors next time. So, let's go ahead and talk with Mr. Mathia Keski, because he's basically our technology stealing guy. We're gonna send you once again off to the Naxilian Union, because they seem to be pretty easy targets for stealing research. And do you have that shield technology? They don't. Darn. Alright, well, I guess we'll get some, I don't know. Maybe we'll go with efficient energy conversion. There we go. Sounds good. So, efficient energy conversion. And our agent Oral Larent has completed his mission to incite a rebellion. Well, you know what? Let's go ahead and get you inciting more rebellions. Let's target. I'm not sure who to target. Great Meridian Alliance or the Naxilian Union. I feel like the Naxilian Union is kind of, they're right next to me and they are annoying me. But I feel like the Great Meridian Alliance is what needs to be taken down a peg. Yes. We'll go with the Great Meridian Alliance. We'll see if we can manage that. So let me take a look. Incite rebellion at colony. Yeah, actually, I think that's who I had you trying to sabotage last time. Okay, let's take a look through here. I want to find one that is above 90%. And I believe this is the one here that we did last time. Sure. Sarancit 4. Let him keep building that up. Yeah, because I'm looking at the Great Meridian Alliance, and I'm like... It might just be because who their neighbors are. They're kind of relatively unopposed. You know, they've had to fight them, but they've also got one of the weakest factions in the game next to them. As well, like... Actually, who are these guys? That is the Srelur Empire. Where do they stand? Overall, the Srelur Empire is one of the lowest ones as well. So I kind of feel like the Great Meridian Alliance has gotten so powerful because they have a lot of, we'll say, weaker territories near them. Let me see, Sluka, right? They're called the Rotal Prime Collective in this game. How strong are these guys? Rotal Prime Collective. They're also down near the bottom. And okay, let's see. What neighbors did we have? The Rhodian Hive was one of the original ones. The Gazurians we knocked down, but even then they're still stronger than all the other neighbors. The Naxxilians are above. We had the Isilis Major Enclave, but we've made friends with them. And the Great Caidian Territory, but we've also made friends with them. And have they made friends with their neighbors? Let's see, the Srelur Empire. Where are you guys? They're cautious, but yeah, they're okay. Who was the other one? Come on. Not Srelur. What color am I looking at? Oh yeah, the Hakonish Syndicate. Okay, they're pleased. So yeah, they're getting along with. At least they're not fighting with their neighbors. But that's probably because of their power. I'm debating. I'm like, the Gazurians keep asking for freedom, and I'm not sure if I want to necessarily give that to them. It's just, I don't know. I'm liking the income that comes from it. I'm liking being able to keep an eye on them. Because if I go ahead and I remove that agreement with them, I really have a feeling I'm going to want to go ahead and crush them. So yeah, maybe it's a better idea, guys. It's in your best interest to stay our subjugated dominion. Because when we actually do start getting a little war crazy, yeah, you'll want to be on our good side. Alright, we had a research setback in... what was that? Rapid assembly. Darn it. That's a technology I definitely wanted. Actually, on that note, let me see here. Where is rapid assembly? Energy and construction. Because that would give us much larger ships. How much does it cost to crash research it? If I get another 200 grand, I can go ahead and do crash research on rapid assembly. See, that's one thing I do like about the cash flow. I'm like, if I keep the cash flow up, I can just start getting tons of money and start doing kind of what I did at the beginning of the game. You know, just initiating lots of crash research on things. Okay, so Strikeforce Alpha sounds like it's made it to the system. Oh, no, seriously? Why aren't you just going to refuel over here? Do they have any fuel on MC Hammer? Let me go ahead and take a look at MC Hammer, because it looks like Strikeforce Alpha wants to go elsewhere to refuel. So if we go look at Cargo, Kazlan, they've got fuel? Why aren't you guys just fueling up here? Where are you? Come on. Refuel all ships at Moon MC Hammer. Come on, people. Don't be picky. How far away are you guys? Yeah, you're right outside the system. Come on. Alright, so Rezu's under attack from pirates. So it looks like we're gonna lose our space station there. Which pirate faction is this? This is the Sakura Ravagers. Okay. Darn it. Looks like the defensive fleet got wrecked too. Okay, so let's see, what fleet is this here? That's Zeta Defense Force. Which only has 3 ships remaining and soon to only have 0 ships remaining. Hmm. Okay. Well, they're escaping. Okay, so what we're gonna do is, where's the next nearest, spaceport? Rhodian Major. So we're gonna go here, zoom in on this planet here, and we're gonna go ahead and, get, at this large spaceport, we're gonna get a 2 carriers, 2 cruisers, 2 destroyers, and go ahead and put those all into the Zeta, Defense Force. We kind of need to, we'll say, rebuild that defense force just a little bit, because it just kind of got torn to shreds. I'm hoping having the 2 carriers and the 2 cruisers will give it that firepower it needs to, we'll say, do its job more effectively. So, darn it, I hate that. The pirates, like I said, they've gotten very vicious lately. Let me see here. Yep. Yeah, there goes one of my cruisers, and those 2 destroyers are gonna go down. Alright. Oh, what's this? Where are you from? You're from the Rhodian Defense Force. Okay. Okay, so I do have, the Rhodian Defense Force. Do I still have them set on a large, yes, I do. Their fleet posture. It also encapsulates the Zeta Pasolo system. I'm wondering if I should start adopting that for some systems. I like that. So basically, what ended up happening was the Zeta Defense Force obviously was not able to do the job well enough. So they got some reinforcements that came in a little bit from the other defense force, the Rhodian Defense Force. Alright, well, the pirates are definitely getting a bit of an edge here. Let's go ahead and build another spaceport and another defensive base. I don't feel like I should be putting 2 defensive bases here because, like I said, we're going to be getting a few, we'll say, beefier ships for the defense force. As well as, you know, there's like, what, 2 other planets in this system. Now, our intelligent agent, Kobe Kalen, has acquired a new character trait, Sober. What does that do again? Kobe Kalen. Kalen? Kalen. Kalen. Sober does +10 to espionage, +10 to counter-espionage, +10 to sabotage, +10 to psyops, and +10 to concealment. Alright, so he gets basically a +10 to everything. But I'm guessing corrupt kind of... Yeah, it just nullifies all those things. So, I guess instead of being -20 to everything, now he's only just -10. So that's good. He's getting better. So and actually, I just sort of started zooming out here from the Zeta Pasolo system, and I noticed right here we at Umwat Major. It looks like we have a pirate base up there. So that's another we'll say pirate base that's actually within our territory. Not cool, people, not cool. So we're gonna have to go ahead and deal with that as well. So yeah, I think for the next little bit we're gonna be it's actually been a little while since we've had problems just dealing with just pirates rather than you know other empires. You know, right now the threat is actually pirates. Darn it. Yeah, they're gonna try to prevent us from rebuilding. And the rest of the defense fleet is not done yet. The Dantha fur supplies have been exhausted on the colony Shan. So basically, just like how sometimes you can discover new resources on planets, sometimes those, we'll say, resources, they disappear as well, or they get used up. So Shan is no longer a source of Dantha fur, so if we want some Dantha fur, we're going to have to find ourselves another source of it. Oh, nice. So fighters from the planet Shan are coming over here to help Rezu. That's cool. And now the Liana Prime 2 mining station is under attack. What is it with you people? Stupid pirates? Man, okay, let's see, Wait, that looks like, yep, that's the Menacing Ravagers. Holy cow. Dude, fire back. Oh, it was incomplete. Okay, it wasn't fully built yet. Huh. What system is that? Althura's major system. Huh. I wonder if we could send a... Actually, wow, look at this. There's a criminal network being set up on this planet by the Sakura Ravagers. So we're about to have another pirate-controlled planet in this system here. Okay. Yeah, the pirates... I'm wondering if it's an AI thing, like, once the legendary pirate faction arrives, do all the other pirates kind of start rallying behind them and getting really aggressive? Because it almost seems that way. Because, look, we're getting constant pirate attacks all over the place. Huh. Okay. So, let's go ahead and, let's actually start doing some stuff. Rather than reacting and going, holy cow, holy cow, holy cow, constantly. Let's go ahead and start, doing some stuff here. We're gonna go ahead and build a, another mining station on this planet, like we were trying to do. Looks like our carrier... Wait, from what? The Liana Defense Force? So this is another... This is actually a completely different system altogether. It's facing off against pirates as well. Ah, that's something that actually I forgot. I noticed it at the end of the last episode, or while I was, right after I was done, I started thinking, I was like, oh, you know, I forgot to do something when I was designing my carriers. So, let's go ahead and, let's look at my carrier. And we're gonna go ahead and under edit. Now, you know, you can't edit the design because it's already in use. However, you can still edit these options up here. And what I want to do is I want to change it so that, I always want to use standoff. Against all enemies when I'm using a carrier. And the reason for that is, standoff tends to make it so that you're using your longest range weapons. So staying far back, firing concussion missiles, and allowing the fighters to do their job, I feel like that's more of what a carrier should be doing. I'm also wondering, flee when shields are at 20%. I think if a carrier is taking enough damage that they get knocked down to, we'll say, 20%, then they're probably not where they should be. And they probably don't have the support they need to keep themselves safe. So I'm actually going to put this to shields 50%. I did want to change the graphic, though. Alright, maybe when we get a larger size. I forgot to change what type of graphic would be used for the carrier. So it basically just looks like our cruisers. But on our next retrofit, our next redesign, I'll make sure that the carriers look unique rather than looking like just larger versions of carriers. All right, so it seems like Liana Prime 10 should be fine. Strike Force Alpha is still refueling. Let's get Charlie and Bravo refueled and refueled and rearmed and repaired and all that as well, because we're getting ready for our attack against the menacing Ravagers. All right, yet more pirate attacks over here in the Zeta Pacelo system. Does look like our defensive fleets are in position though to intercept. What I've decided to go ahead and do though is I'm actually starting to build up another strike force. So I've got Strike Force Alpha, Bravo, and Charlie, and I'm creating one which I'm basically just calling Pirate Crushers. And their job is going to be to just crush pirates. Now, on that note, they're only cruisers and carriers, but if I recall correctly, my cruisers are set up with troop compartments, so they should be able to do planetary invasions as well. And that's good because if, you know, the pirates have troops on a planet, we want to make sure that they are, that they're dealt with. A new colony governor named Jiren Nothrus has appeared on the blue planet. Okay. I can't remember if there was a governor sitting on the blue planet when the coup d'etat happened. I'll have to go back and maybe look at the save game and see if maybe I forgot to allocate someone to another planet. But I find it's usually the person that's sitting on the planet that tends to initiate the coup d'etat. So, what I am thinking is that I should go ahead and maybe move him to another planet. So let's see what this new colony governor can do. Let's see, the blue planet. He's good at military ship construction speed, colony happiness, colony income, and colony corruption reduction. I want to find the planet in my system with the highest corruption, and I want to slap him over there. So Jaron Nothris. Let's take a look at our colonies. Zero corruption. We have 40% corruption on Gazuria 1. That's quite a bit. So far, that's the highest one we've got. Let's see. 17, 15, 6, 5, 6, 5, 3, 5, 5, 11, 3, 2, 2, 0. So yeah, Gazuria 1 is where I need this guy. Darn it. On the one hand, I'm sad we lost the mining base. On the other hand, I'm glad that the pirates basically took the bait and are getting totally shredded by Strike Force Alpha. It's just, it's majestic, it's beautiful. Yes. Take that, scum. Let's see. Ealing Mining Station is under attack. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. So we've got two mining stations that are apparently under attack. Yeah, I don't think the destroyers are going to make it over there. I think that's what the intention of these destroyers was to warp over there and attack those mining bases, but they're not getting away from this. So let's go ahead and send our guy, Mr. Colony Governor, let's see, Jaron Nothris, let's send him over to Gazuria 1. And, let's see, colony income, colony happiness, this is a perfect fit for him, because... And it's also going to knock down the corruption. He's going to make us a lot of money in that system. So, excellent. So, Strike Force Alpha, you're not fueled up, so could you please go ahead and do that? That would be excellent if you could do that. Please. I still don't know why they seem so intent on leaving system to refuel and... crap, but... whatever. Whatever. Do your thing, people! Just be stupid. Do your thing. I don't even know. Oh, or is that just the main ship wants to go down there? No, the whole fleet is going. All right. Okay, well let me see here. The main the ships tend to be going down there. Let's go ahead and take a look here. Pirates secretly funded to attack, Rover Prime Collective, I don't care, keep it to information to ourselves. If they get destroyed, I really don't care. Let's go ahead and take a look at this. This cruiser is of design, what is it, Alliance or Allegiance 3 Mark II. What kind of fuel do you use? Because I just thought about that, I'm like, are we using hydrogen yet? I checked for Kazlon, but let's take a look at where's your reactor? Where is your reactor? I'm just blind, aren't I? Come on, quantum reactor. Well, that's still Kazlon. I'm not sure why they would go down there. Is it because there's not enough fuel? I'm wondering. Let me see, fuel. So if each one takes about 400... If each one takes about 400 points... Yeah, this guy's getting destroyed. About 400 points, and Planet MC Hammer... only had... Let's see how much that planet had. I'm trying to figure out why they wouldn't want to go ahead and just refuel at the planet right there in their system. Let's see, cargo. And as far as Kazlon goes, you don't have any. All right, they just don't have any Kazlon. I thought they did a second ago. I guess. I don't know, other ships, other bases, or, I don't know, I guess some, they got emptied out. I guess, there was too much that was used. Alright, so, evidently, there is no more fuel on MC Hammer. So that's going to definitely slow down our missions in this area, because, both Strike Force Charlie and Bravo need to get refueled so that we can go up and attack this pirate base. Alright, our agent Oral Laurent has evaded detection after having successfully incited a rebellion at Sarancid 4. Let's see. We've also stolen research information on efficient energy conversion, obviously, because we've actually completed research in that area. So, Let's go ahead and get them back on their respective missions. So, wow, we are getting a whole lot of intelligence agents. I feel like we're kind of underutilizing them. We've got great counterintelligence, but I feel like maybe we're underutilizing our offensive abilities here. So, Oral Larent, you're pretty good at psyops, but I'm not sure if you're good enough yet. Let's go ahead and see here. We're going to go ahead and incite rebellion at Colony Sorensit 4. You went down by one. Actually, did it go down by 1% or up by 1%? See, are there any other planets that you could realistically tackle? I'm not so sure. You know what? This is the best chance. We're building up your abilities. We're going to go ahead and send you again against the Great Meridian Alliance. I feel like that's who we should be tackling. So, Mathia Keski, though, like I said, he's my research stealing guy. When it comes to research stealing, I don't care who I target. I just want the resources, right? So let's go ahead and, I don't know what I want. I did want long-range projectiles. I like using railguns, but I feel like there's so much armor on ships at this point that they're probably not, all that effective. So, I'm just gonna start grabbing stuff at the top and working my way through it. So we've got those two out on missions. Let's see what else we've got here. You're gonna counter espionage, we're gonna leave you be. Gray Fox, you've got inspiring presence, we're gonna leave you be as well. So these two we're gonna leave. Luke Moretti, you're good at psyops. Maybe we should be sending you on. Actually, let's send you on the same mission as our diet friend here, and get you to incite a rebellion on Sorensit 4. So we'll have maybe we can actually cause the entire planet just to be able to cause two big hits one after the other, and it'll cause them to actually separate. That would be very cool. So we've got these two intelligence agents doing the exact same psyops mission, and hopefully that will cause some real problems on that one planet. Now, Hugo, you're untested. So if you could go ahead and I just need you to steal, I don't know, a territory map. Who do we actually want to know more about, though? I feel like... Let's see, who do we want to steal a territory map of? I'm wondering, Menacing Ravagers. Pirates tend to be pretty dangerous doing missions against. But let's see, territory map, let's see if... 86%, no. I'm wondering, is that just because they're the legendary clan? Let's see, how long would it take you to steal the territory map of, the Lennis clan, 86. So, yeah, the pirates are a little bit harder to, we'll say, infiltrate. I'm not sure who I'd want to send them out against. Let's just go ahead and send them against the Rhodian Hive. Because if I recall correctly, they're pretty, terrible at espionage, and we should, being untested, we'll send him against the Rhodian Hive to kind of just steal their territory map and figure out what they're doing. Alright, so we've got 1.9 million. To do crash research, we need 1.7 million, because you know we've done research in the meantime on Rapid Assembly. So I'm going to initiate crash research on Rapid Assembly. And that is going to speed up that research, and that's going to give us some even larger ships, which is excellent. Now, Strike Force Bravo, you guys appear to be nice and fueled up. I'm wondering if Strike Force Bravo can handle this base on their own. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually get Strike Force Bravo to warp in right about here. I'm going to tell them to warp in about here, and that should put them close, actually right about, maybe about here. There we go. And that should put them close enough that they'll manually move over and attack this defensive battery. And this will give them the option to sort of back out or escape, you know, if they start taking too much fire. Because I'm still not too sure exactly how strong these things are going to be. Like, their size of 795, that's pretty big. But let me take a look here. What have we got? We've got, we're size 500. We should have enough firepower to take those down, but just in case, like I said, I don't want to just warp right on into the middle and then get everyone torn to shreds and then be, you know, panicking and pull everyone out, get everyone out! Yeah, I don't want that to happen. So we've actually had an a mining station completely destroyed. And that's probably because of an intelligence mission. Wow, Yuffie's under attack. Let's see, by the Fearsome Merchant Cartel. Huh. Well, let's see if Yuffie's defense force has enough firepower to defend the planet, or if I need to beef up my defenses even more. Let's see. Dang, they've got some pretty large ships. I can't tell what's happening. Everyone's all bunched up. Okay, let me see. Let me take a look at my the spaceport. The spaceport is... It is taking damage. The shields appear to be going down. But the pirates do appear to be in retreat. Yeah, so... We took some hits, but I think ultimately it's going to stay up. Yeah. So I'd say we had just enough defenses. Yeah. Just enough defenses to be effective here. The defensive base looks like it's going to hold. Yeah. Okay, so we're good. So I'm going to actually give the order for the Yuffie spaceport to... No, I can't get it to retrofit because it's damaged. All right, that's fine. And that fleet is automated, so it should be able to go ahead and it'll repair itself all automatically. I was worried though that I'd miss Strike Force Bravo arriving here at the menacing Ravagers base here. But nope. We had just enough time to check out the fight on Yuffie and be back in time for Strike Force Bravo's little assault. Let's see how well they do. Another carrier is under attack. Yeah, this is not going to go well for them. Alright, back to Strike Force Bravo. Alright, Strike Force Bravo has, partially arrived in system. So let's get them to all focus fire on this defensive base first. Let's see how this turns out. So the carriers have gone ahead and they've launched their fighter complements. And, man, carriers are very useful. Man, fighters are just... Fighters are fantastic. You stay at range. I find a lot of the AI likes to focus... They tend to fire at what's closest to them, right? So when you have a bunch of fighters kind of moving in... Oh, crap. One of our carriers looks like it's taking a lot of damage. Yeah, you need to escape, buddy. Get out of there. Get out of there. Crap, are we gonna lose a carrier? Yeah, it looks like the defensive base's fighters really chipped away at this carrier. But that's okay. That's okay. We took down one of the defensive bases. And it looks like... Yeah, the ship... It's only got 7 components damaged. I'm curious. I want to see which components were damaged. I'm pretty sure that's probably just going to be armor. It always looks bad because you got all these holes on the ship and you're like, no! But we look at how much armor is still on there. It's actually not a whole lot of armor. I'm like, alright, we've got these little pieces here, but it still has enough armor. So, the carrier is, it looks bad, like it's gotten through the shields, but I feel like it's holding. Yeah, so I think this is going to be a successful strike from Strike Force Bravo. I'm pretty sure that base is going to go down. Yeah. So, we're going to go ahead and laugh at the menacing Ravagers because, They were obviously not capable of defending their base. Take that, you scum buckets. I don't know, scum bucket just sounds like a cool insult. I don't know. Maybe not. I'm old. Keep take that into account. So carrier decisive resistance is under attack from a pirate destroyer. Somehow I feel like that's going to be less interesting than this, but let's go ahead and take a look anyways. Yeah, I was right. That was definitely less interesting. Alright, so let's go ahead and watch them finish this off, and then I guess we will get back to more important matters like dealing with other pirates. Actually, speaking of pirates, how is my pirate crushing fleet doing? Let me take a look here. Rodian Reach. Oh, there we go. Pirate Crushers! There we go. They're not doing anything. Well, you know what? We should assign them a mission. They only have 1,000 firepower, though. That's not a lot of firepower. Okay, I'll leave these guys do their thing. It's obvious that we've destroyed that. I need to be managing things elsewhere in the empire. I can't get totally tunnel visioned here. It's generally not a good thing. What are you guys doing? Bounty Hunter's retreat destroyed. We've destroyed the pirate base Bounty Hunter's retreat of the menacing ravagers. We found a data core floating in the debris of the destroyed base. In the data core, we have found a huge store of technology research that has given us breakthroughs in the following areas: long-range projectiles, refined hyper-jump theory, high-powered tractor beams, an open trade network, and advanced passenger transport. Wow, this is a great victory over our nemesis, the menacing ravagers. So by destroying their base, we got a bunch of technological breakthroughs? Oh, that is great! That is fantastic. Wow. Okay. That is awesome. And you're gonna go ahead and destroy that base, right? Yeah? Cool. Just wanted to make sure that they were gonna destroy the other defensive base. So back to the sort of the pirate crushers here. They've only got 1,172 firepower, and if we compare that to, like, Strikeforce Bravo, which has, let's see, 13 ships. They've got a slightly, they've got a fewer number of ships. It makes me wonder how effective they're going to be against, let's say, this base here, the Sakura Ravagers. Let me see, do we know how strong that base is? Secret base. It looks like at least 2,000 firepower. So maybe the pirate crushers are just not big enough yet. Maybe we need to beef their numbers up before they can actually be pirate crushers and not so much just pirate annoyers. Ah, sigh. Yes, I just said sigh. sometimes you talk the way you type. You know, sometimes when you're talking, like, I use IRC still. I still use chat things, right? Chat clients. You tend to, say, type out your emotions or what you're thinking or slash feeling. And, I don't know, every once in a while that'll come out in speech as well. It's interesting how, I don't know how that works. So, I'm gonna go ahead and I built a few more ships that I'm gonna be rolling into my pirate crushers. We'll say strike force, just because, like I said, I want them to actually be pirate crushers, not, you know, just minor thorns in their side or, you know, like I said before, pirate annoyers. All right, so I think that maybe a little bit less focus on the military side of things now. I feel like, okay, we've gone ahead and we've wiped out that base. We've wiped that all out. We can get Strike Force Bravo back to... Dang, are you still fighting that thing? Yep, you are still trying to destroy that thing. Okay, come on, guys. Okay, you can go ahead repair and refuel. Let's go ahead and take a look at our taxes screen. I want to see where our money is. I'm loving where our money's at right now. You know, 500 grand. We're making lots of cash. We've got lots of ships. We're able to deal with any threat that's, you know, coming towards our empire. So our military is top. It's primo. It is awesome. And we just got ourselves a new colony. You know what? This is the perfect time to go ahead to the colony screen and go ahead and see. And now I can start telling people, get your crap out of my system. So let's go ahead and do just that. So we'll look at the colony screen in just a second, but I want to talk to these people here, the Hakonish Syndicate. And I'm going to send a warning. I'm going to tell them, remove your military forces from our territory. We see no need to remove our ships from the Escobar Minor System. The Escobar Minor System. Really? Maybe it hasn't ticked over yet. Maybe you haven't got the memo that we own this territory. All right, well, you know what? We're going to go ahead and take a look at the colony screen. And if they haven't moved their stuff in like a month... Oh yeah, there they go. There they go. I was gonna say then we'll blow them out of the sky, as it were, even though we're not in the sky. I'm a little bit disappointed. I was kind of hoping to be like, nope, get out. This is my place. So the new planet we got was Nemben Junction 1. It's an ice planet and has insufficient strategic resources, which is slowing development and population growth. Yes, I know. I'm very sorry to you people. We're gonna go ahead and get you guys a small garrison starting to be built. And I'm not even sure if we're gonna go ahead and build a spaceport here. I feel like we're not gonna have a lot of ships coming to this base. It's such a low quality, I'm not expecting it to really be developed. I mostly did it just, like I said, to expand my borders. So I think that that might be one of the planets that we actually just leave without a spaceport. You know, ships can go ahead and land on it one by one manually. Don't really think we need any more than that. So the Great Canyon Territory has gotten a deadly plague. That's unfortunate for them. Yep, I think that that's good. Now, I'm really debating. Can we tell them to get their construction ship out of our system? I'm kind of torn here. Whoa, what the heck is going on? What the heck is going on? Let's back things up here. I'm getting a ton of wars being declared. Let's take a look at what's going on here. So the Rotal Prime Collective, that's these purple guys, declared war on the Naxilian Union, which is all the way over here. Okay. And the Gazurian Conformity declared war on these guys, the Hakonish, these guys that we are messing with a little bit. You know, I'm okay with that. I feel like, you know, I would actually help out the Gazurians in this one. Actually, the Hakonish Syndicate has declared war on the Rhodian Hive, so now they're declaring war on these guys. Let's see, the Royal Prime Collective is declared war on the Rindula colonies, and if I recall correctly, those are the Mortalans down here. So the purple and the red are at war. And then we've got the Rindula colonies, the Mortalans, they're declaring war on the Rhodians. The Rhodian Hive has declared war on the Naxilian Union. The Naxilian Union has declared war on the Gazurians. Oh man, this is so interesting. The Gazurian Conformity has declared war on the Rindula colonies. Huh. You know what I'm actually tempted to do? Wait, Rindula colonies. Who's the Rindula colonies again? That's... There's so many wars right now! No, this is the Rotal Prime Collective, so who's the Rindula colonies? I don't remember who those are. Regardless, I'm almost tempted... Actually, I'm really debating this. Of, siding with the Xurians. Basically, they like our new form of government. And I'm actually considering maybe making them our next... I don't think I can make them our next mutual defense pact. Because they're so weak. The Tekken Corporation and the Rhodian Hive were at war, but that has now ended. You know what I'm gonna do? No, I'm gonna think about it. And maybe I'll come back to it next time. But what I was thinking was... Let's see here. The Gazurian Conformity. They're pleased with us. Because they like our government. It gives us them a plus 15. If we get rid of the subjugation with them, against them, I'm wondering if we could work on our relationship with them. They're right next to us. It would kind of work. And we already know that they're not on good terms with it's two of the factions that we actually want to mess with right now. The Naxilian Union, for instance. And the Hakonish Syndicate. I'm indifferent about the Rindula colonies, though, the Mortalans, but... Oh, this is, actually, I never thought that, you know, maybe it'd be cool to be friends with the Gazurians. And I would keep trading Zentabia fluid with them. You know what? I want to try it. But we're getting a lot of money from them. That's a tough one. But we are getting trade with them anyways. Well, you would get trade either way. And they're also very unreliable. But I feel like that would kind of sort of secure this entire section. What do the Rhodians think of us? I'm just curious now. Where are you guys at? Rhodians. They like our style of government. So the bug races will like our style of government. You know, I'm gonna think about it. I'm going to think about it a little bit and debate if I want to, we'll say, route one, release them from subjugation, and then two, see about actually maybe getting on better terms with them. And then we'll have our, like, great alliance to deal with the great Meridian alliance. Yeah. Now, I did say we were going to look at the colony screen, and it took me forever to do that. I want to take a look at, we'll say, the tax that we are putting on our planets here. It does appear that... Wait. 40% corruption still? Really? What is your, We sent a new colony governor over there, and he is there. We don't know what his colony corruption reduction is yet. So hopefully in time we'll discover what it is, and we'll be able to, we'll say, make some more money here. But the nice thing is, they're happy. Which means we can get a little bit more money out of them. So I'm going to bring their tax rate up to about 15%. Elysium, my goodness, you people are very happy, which means give me more money. I'm going to try to put a cap of about 30%. I don't want to go over that. These guys are, they're happy, but it's like a marginal happy. If something big happened to our empire, I feel like Dagon would kind of crumble. It would get into the neutral, sad. It'd be sort of a contender for, rebellion if we waited much longer. So, Kilimar 3, it looks like you're still developing for whatever reason, but we're going to go ahead and that's probably just because some of your population left. We're going to go ahead and add another 3 points of tax to you. Rodian Major 1, let's go ahead and bring you up to about 13%. Liana Prime 10, one more point up to 30. Oh yeah, we're just grabbing like all kinds of cash from these people because, like I said, it's time to really get lots of cash. We're gonna do crash research, and I hate to say the term. I don't want to steamroll the game, but I feel like now I'm at the point that unless something truly crazy happens, we've kind of secured our victory. And I guess I'm a little bit disappointed by that. I wish maybe that. I hate playing, I've recently been playing a little bit more on a higher difficulty level. Just to, you know, add a little bit more of a challenge to it. But I hate that the way the difficulty is managed in this game is, it basically just changes the mechanics for you, rather than actually making the AI more, vicious. Now, there are mods that kind of tweak that and make it a little bit better, but I'm not a big fan of using mods for stuff like that. I don't know, I like vanilla games. Like, I do play with mods, I do definitely like using mods. But I feel like I like doing that after I've played enough of the game in its vanilla state. So let's see, cash flow is at 124. What is that gonna go up to with my tax increases? Okay, so we've got a couple ships over here. So it doesn't look like there's been a huge increase. That might go ahead and change. Maybe I haven't given it enough time. But I feel like it should. We did a lot of, we'll say, percentage increases. There we go, 186. Yeah, we are rolling in the dough at this point. And, you know, there's still untapped taxes that I didn't even touch. I deliberately... I'm holding back on taxing some places more than I actually am. That way there, that... You know, at least that way there I have some, we'll say, room to go if I really need to go to war, you know, against the entire galaxy or whatever. But anyways, we're gonna go ahead and stop things here. So I'm gonna go ahead and save the game as LP33 because this is after our 33rd outing in Distant Worlds Universe. So if you like the video and you like the content and you would like to see more of it, go ahead and give the video a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, leave it a thumbs down. Either way, let me know in the comment section why you liked it or you didn't like it, whatever your thoughts might be, anything at all. But yeah, until next time, I'd like to ask you all to game on.